Abdul Hamid Khan, one of Gilgit Baltistan's most influential leaders who lives in exile in Belgium, said that the terrorist strike on Indian Border Security Force camp near Srinagar Airport has categorically confirmed that Pakistan is using terror as an instrument to not only create instability in neighboring India, but also to subjugate the people of Gilgit Baltistan, who want nothing less than freedom.
Pakistan to demography ko to intentionally change kar raha hai. और वहाँ अपने टेरेस को बसा रहा हूँ, टेरेस को फुल वेपन लेके। जब ये गिलबस्तान के जो इंडिजिनस शहरी है उनसे तमाम वेपन्स, उनको कोई चाकू भी रखने की इजाज़त नहीं, उनसे सारे उठा लिए। और अगर किसी के हमारे लोगों पे इल्ज़ाम लगाएगा, खुद अपने वेपन पे लगाएगा, उनको टेरेस एक्ट के तहत अंडर भी कर लिया। बाकी किसी को हथियार रखने की परमिशन नहीं है। और सेक्टेरियन लेवल पर कुछ जगहों में परमिशन उनको दी है फ्री, उनके पास रॉकेट लॉन्चर हो, वो मशीन गन हो, जो भी हो वो रख सकते हैं। बाकी अपने जो पाकिस्तानी शहरी है वहाँ वो सब कुछ रख सकते हैं उनके पास। तो कल अगर कोई बात होगी तो वही पाकिस्तानी शहरी, वही आईएसआई के एजेंट ही है, वही ट्रेन लोग हैं, वही टेररिस्ट है, वो लोकल लोगों का तो जेनोसाइड कर सकते हैं वो किसी भी स्टेज में। तो लोकल लोग बहुत ही खतरे में हैं वहाँ उस वक्त।
He squarely blamed Islamabad for using terrorists to create a divide among the people in the name of religion and sect.
After 1988, General Zia, he attacked, he used his Today they are called ISR Taliban. At that time they were called as Mujahideen. And he used his so-called terrorist by naming the Mujahideen. They attacked Gilgit Baltistan indigenous people. They were mostly Shias. They were dislodged. They were killed. The ladies were kidnapped. Their mosque along with the holy books, Quran, was burned down. But up till today, they displaced people. Cannot return to their homes. They are totally also they are displaced, and you know no justice done with that. Nobody has been arrested or trial in that case, in that killing. 1,000 people were killed at that time.
Khan, who is heading the Balawaristan National Front, a political party based in Gilgit Baltistan, claimed that none of the people in the region are happy to live under Pakistan's control.
And as far as the UNCIP is concerned, the people of Gilgit Baltistan and the people of Jammu and Kashmir, the people of Ladakh, they don't have the third choice. There are only two options. Either you can vote to India or you can vote to Pakistan. And after the long 69 years experience, we the people of Gilgit Baltistan, we are living under the durance of Pakistan, under the occupation of Pakistan. And we live like in a prison of 72,000 square miles. And by keeping that in our mind, if we have only two options, we will not give our vote to Pakistan. We will vote for India. That's why we are requesting to Pakistan, let us to be free.
He added that the lives, property and freedom of people is under serious threat due to Pakistan and China's joint conspiracy to strengthen their occupation under the garb of China-Pakistan Economic Corridor.
CPEC doesn't enter to Pakistan, CPEC enters to Gilgit Baltistan. The Gilgit Baltistan is the first victim, you can say. I don't use the word of area, it's the first victim of CPEC. Because the Chinese government, they did not talk with the representative, any so-called representative, the GBLA or its governor or its chief minister. They didn't take them into account.
Spread in an area of over 28,000 square miles, Gilgit Baltistan was part of princely state of Jammu and Kashmir. It remains under Pakistani occupation since 1948.